What's up? How's everybody doing? I just had a new one happen to me right now. Now, I get people from time to time, they cancel my service, which is fine. You know, you're not locked in. You could sign up for a 30-day free trial. You could subscribe for a while. You could cancel. Usually, when people cancel, they say something like, it's not my style, all right? I've been over that excuse. I mean, there's only two styles. There's winning and there's losing. And when my service has had an unbroken track record of wins, zero losses, if you're saying it's not my style, you're basically saying your style is losing. But I understand that now, that most people, they cannot handle the stress of the market. They create that stress within themselves. They cannot handle that. And they choose to be weak. They choose to give up, to quit, to not try to develop strength, to develop resiliency, to develop a mindset to rise above adversity. And like many of you now are realizing that these concepts about mental game, they're not just applicable to the market, they're applicable to your personal life, your life. I mean, a lot of you are commenting, hey, Mike, this stuff is helping me in life. But anyway, I had a new one today because I've heard, you know, most excuses. Some people are just quiet. They say cancel. A lot of people say it's not my style. I had one guy right now who told me he's going to prison. Now, folks, you don't have to make up wild stories. And I know for a fact the guy's not going to prison. You don't have to make up wild stories to cancel. Send me an email. Say you want to cancel. Or if you want to, you know, pretend that it's not your style, even though I can see right through that, then you could send that as well in an email. If you want to cancel, you send an email. All right, let's get to the more important stuff, which is the markets and the economic data. So we saw a tremendous blowout ADP jobs report this morning, 298,000. I think they were looking for something like 187,000, 190,000. So it was huge. It was a huge number. And I suspect Friday's jobs number from the government will also be strong. I mean, if I look at the data from February, if I look at employment and withholding tax deposits, employment and withholding tax deposits doesn't necessarily tell us about new payrolls or new jobs being created. It could go up just based on rising salaries and wages, all right? So got to be careful with that one. But right now, that data in February is very strong. It's not as strong as January, but it is stronger than last February. So with a seasonal adjustment and the fact that it's stronger than last February, looks like a good report, or at least a good report in terms of hourly earnings, you know, wages and salaries. If I look at unemployment benefits being paid out, that's way, way down. If I look at initial claims for unemployment benefits, that's down to almost like a 50-year low. So there's nothing that I could see in the data which conflicts with sort of the result that we saw in the ADP number today. So you saw the typical zombie reaction. They bought the dollar. They sold gold. Fine. All right. I'm telling you right now, I'm going to repeat again. When this plays out, the dollar is going to be a lot lower, gold is going to be a lot higher, and the stock market is going to go lower. And here's the thing I want to talk about. Very interesting. Now, I've been mentioning the data that, first of all, I've been talking about the flows. The fiscal flows have been flat year over year. No spending growth. No spending growth. Doesn't mean they're not spending. No spending growth. Flat year over year. And that's even with the recovery in the IRS tax refunds, okay? So that's number one. And you know, that's the main thing that I look at. Second thing, of course, you know, I've been talking about the collapse in bank credit growth. Again, not the nominal amount, but bank credit growth, the collapse. And then I've been talking about the actual economic data that we have been seeing. Worst trade deficit in 5 years. We got that number yesterday. We know that net exports, that component of GDP, was the main negative in the fourth quarter GDP, which brought it down to 1.9%. Durable goods orders, when you take out transportation, that was negative. personal consumption expenditures, real personal consumption expenditures, in other words, adjusted for inflations, that was negative. And by the way, you got to go all the way back. It was negative. You got to go all the way back to 2009 to see a negative print like the one we saw in January. Construction spending down. What else? We had some little small, we didn't get the inventory numbers for January, but we had huge inventory build in the fourth quarter. Anyway, I've been saying all this stuff looks like a weak GDP for the first quarter. And guess what? The Atlanta Fed, which publishes this index called GDP Now, where they forecast, and you can get this on the FRED database, that's the St. Louis Fed database online, is now forecasting a 1.3% growth rate for the first quarter. So I had all these numbers, I had the forecast, and I'll tell you, stock market way up here, growth in the third quarter of last year, 3.5%, growth in the fourth quarter, 1.9%, growth in the first quarter of this year now, 1.3% if we're lucky. If you get a sell-off in the stock market in March now, don't forget we got the debt ceiling coming up, we'll have negative growth for the first quarter. So stocks are in trouble. Dollar is at a peak here, a major, major long-term peak here. Fed's going to raise interest rates. Gold is a major, major buy here, even though people don't want to own it, which is, that's the kind of bull market I love. And so that's the update for now. You're not going, folks, you don't have to say you're going to prison. If you want to cancel, just send me an email saying you want to cancel. But hopefully you don't, and hopefully you want to sign up. Because again, this is the only service you're going to find where every single closeout trade has been a profit. Look, if you're weak, if you don't want to strengthen, I can't deal with people who choose to be victims of their own behavior. I mean, if you're not willing to change yourself, if you're not willing to toughen yourself up, if you're not willing to make yourself resilient, if you're not willing to deal with adversity, not just in the market, but in your life, there is nothing that I can do for you. And you must understand that you have chosen to lose, not just in the market, but in life. Okay, you have chosen to lose, and you are, that is the definition of a loser. Can't help you. You got to at least try. You got to at least try, people. See you later. Bye.